A frissonnoir was never really a movement, although later it was described as such many times. But initially it was just a title that Lindsay Anderson coined for a program of films which were very different and which were not produced together. They just happened to come together. And Lindsay coined this phrase, free cinema, and there was a manifesto issued, rather a grand title, just a few lines, which was signed, a manifesto was issued, and this manifesto was signed by the four directors concerned, Lindsay Anderson, Karel Reisz, Tony Richardson, Lorenza Mazzetti, and by myself and John Fletcher. And it would be quite interesting to quote from that. I haven't got it in front of me here, but we can have a look at it later. And so Free Cinema was the showing at the National Film Theatre in 1956, I think it must have been, 55, 56, of Momma Don't Allow, Oh Dreamland, and Together, which, as I've already said, were three very different films made under different circumstances. Oh Dreamland was a little film that Lindsay made on his own, off his own bat. Oh Dreamland was a little film that Lindsay made with his own money, and John Fletcher did the photography, at the time when Lindsay and I were together in Margate making the film Thursday's Children. So he got interested in the pleasure affair called Dreamland, and he made this little film there quite quickly with John on camera, and when it was finished, it was a 10-minute short, and it was very critical of the people in Dreamland. It wasn't a very people-friendly film, you could say, but it was very astute, and it shows a very, very good picture of Britain in the 50s. And this was the first in the programme. The second was Momma Don't Allow, which was a film made under the aegis of the British Film Institute. At that time it was called the Experimental Film Fund. Later it was called the Production Board, but initially it was called the BFI Experimental Film Fund. They provided the money, and Tony Richardson and Karel Reisz directed it jointly. But each one took care of a separate section of the film. They never worked together, except in the dance hall, which was really mainly Tony's thing, but they were both together in the dance hall. But in the sequences of the with which the film starts with the participants in the dance hall, each section was directed by either Lindsay or Karel, by either Karel or Tony, separately. And I say somewhere that Momma Don't Allow is a film made with a bowlex and a ladder, because all we had for camera was this spring-wound bowlex, which is a very nice camera and quite professional, but it has a spring motor, so the longest take you can have is 22 seconds. And the ladder came in handy, which was just erected among the dancers, and the dancers were instructed to dance around us like we weren't there, so we were able to get these top shots, of which there's quite a few in the film. And it was Chris Barber's jazz band. And it features, the main dancers are people whose careers we followed, or whose jobs we followed in the introductory section. So we know there's four people, I think, who form the center group in the film, two couples. And we followed them. We see that one of the girls cleans railway carriages, one is a dentist's assistant, one of the boys is a butcher's assistant, and I forget what the fourth one did. Anyway, they were followed in their jobs, and then they all come together in this dance hall for a weekly rock event. Not rock, jazz. Traditional jazz. And that film was very successful, not only to my mind, but that was the general opinion. It was a very successful film. And for years later, I used to get checks for 13 and sixpence, because the film actually brought in money. And it couldn't have cost more than about £250 to make. But money kept coming in drips and drabs for this film, which went on for quite a while and is now a real little classic.